हेलो, गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे इन ऑफलाइन क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड SCR, शॉर्ट सर्क्यूट रेशो एज कंसर्न टू थ्री फेस इंडक्शन मोटर. SCR इज अ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस दैट इज इन पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, दैट इज डिफरेंट. हियर इन थ्री फेस इंडक्शन मशीन्स SCR मीन्स शॉर्ट सर्क्यूट रेशो. So SCR is defined as the ratio of field current required to produce the rated voltage on open circuit to the field current required to circulate rated current at short circuit. Already you are knowing how to plot the OCC, open circuit characteristics, and how to plot the short circuit characteristics by varying synchronous generator excitation. That means by varying field current. As you change the DC current, that field current OCC goes on changing, SCC also goes on changing by conducting open circuit test and short circuit test. Already you are knowing, you plot the graph, then after that you write the definition. SCR equal to field current required to produce the rated voltage on open circuit to the field current required to circulate rated current on short circuit. So both are field currents. Now you can refer the diagram. OFA, O2FA, it is field current required to produce rated voltage on open circuit of the terminals. Open circuit means the terminals of the alternator are kept open. Between any two terminals, line voltage is available. So this is one fact. Second one, OFB, observe that. OFB is the field current required to develop the rated current at the short circuit conditions. That means the terminals of the alternators are shorted. All three terminals are shorted. So you are getting the idea. Now OFA, O2FA, it is field current to develop the rated voltage on open circuit, and OFB is the field current to develop the rated current at short circuit. So as per the above equation or from the definition, now SCR equal to, we shall write OFA to OFB. OFA, once again, field current to develop the rated voltage on OCC. OFB, once again, field current required to develop the rated current at short circuit. You cleanly observe from the graph, OFA is approximately equal to CFA and OFB is approximately equal to BFB. Hence, you can write this one. You replace the above things. So finally, I conclude BFB is per unit open circuit volt, CFA per unit short circuit current. So this ratio can be replaced by XD, where XD is direct access reactance. It is the part of synchronous reactance of synchronous machine. So SCR, finally you write, put the block SCR inversely proportional to XD, where XD is direct access reactance of synchronous machine. For turbo alternator, the SCR value varies from 0.5 to 0.7. For salient pole hydroelectric generators, SCR value varies from 1 to 1.5. So that is the definition of SCR. What do you mean by SCR? Question continues. Discuss the effect of SCR on performance of machine. So always you write the first factors affects on the performance of machine. So the selection of SCR will affect on the performance of the machine as shown below. Number one, voltage regulation. Number two, stability. Number three, parallel operation. Number four, short circuit current. Number five, self excitation. If you are able to write these factors very first, then you may eligible to get 1 to 2 marks. After that, you go on discussion. Number 1, voltage regulation. So you write always, try to insert the formulas, very small small relations, it will help for the evaluators. So voltage regulation, it is already well known fact that generated voltage across the terminals, it is known as terminal voltage. All alternators are connected in parallel before going to parallel connection. So depending upon the load condition, terminal voltage should not change more from no load to full load condition. So that already you are knowing what you meant by voltage regulation, the change in voltage from no load to full load. So in case of transformer, in case of alternators, this voltage regulation must be low to give the good performance or less fluctuation in terminal voltage from load conditions. Load may be applied, load may be removed. Voltage fluctuation must be very small. Such alternators are required. Hence, you can observe the synchronous reactance is inversely proportional to SCR. That means at low value of SCR, machine will develop larger value of direct excess reactance, XD. Hence, if direct excess reactance is high, then voltage fluctuation should be more. That is, voltage regulation of the machine is poor. Remember, XD should be small. This occurs, SCR should be high. Getting the idea? Try to relate from this expression, at lower value of SCR, higher reactance is developed. Higher reactance will cause poor regulation of machine. Understand? Number two, stability. In power system, the power transfer takes place between any two points is given by following expression. Voltages between two points, V1, V2, and synchronous reactance or direct excess reactance. Direct excess reactance is the part of synchronous reactance of machine. So V1, V2, XD, sine of load angle. This is power transfer. This maximum power transfer occurs, then stability is good. But as the lower value of SCR, higher value of synchronous reactance is developed. Hence, machine possesses lower stability limit. XD is high, power transfer is low. Hence, the stability limit is low. You understand? Because of maximum power output of machine inversely proportional to XD, such a value should be selected. Parallel operation. Again, you develop the expression, same thing. SCR is inversely proportional to XD. SCR is directly proportional to synchronizing power. It is well known fact, to operate the synchronous machines or synchronous generators in parallel operation, always there is a need of synchronism power, synchronizing power. If synchronizing power is more, then all alternators are working synchronism with healthy condition. If synchronizing power reduces, then there is a chance all machines are not working in synchronism. Understand? Hence, machines with having lower value of SCR results higher value of synchronous reactance. Then it will produce lower value of synchronizing power. Less value of SCR develops higher value of synchronous reactance. Then SCR directly proportional to synchronizing power. If SCR is low, synchronizing power is also low. Then there is a difficulty or complex in parallel operation of alternators. Try to understand. Short circuit current. Again, you develop the relation. What is the short circuit current? it is directly proportional to SCR. That means if machines is characterized by low value of SCR, then current produced at short circuit condition is also low. Depending upon design of synchronous machines, this SCR value should be selected. Lastly, we have to discuss self-excitation. The machines feeding to long transmission lines should not be designed with a smaller value of SCR. Smaller value of SCR results larger value of XD. This result into larger voltages on open circuit, which is produced by self-excitation due to capacitive currents drawn by the transmission lines. Hence, these all factors will affect on the performance of alternators or synchronous machines. It is well-known question for VTU. It may be asked in second question for 10 marks. What do you mean by SCR? And briefly discuss the factors affects on performance of machine. So prepare, sir. Next class, I will going to design of field current. That is the last part of synchronous machine. Thank you to one and all.